This video is brought to you by Keybar, so stick to the end of the video to learn more. Hey Weavers, Tim here again, and I have a problem. My keys are too heavy. Now this is a problem because apparently having keys that are too heavy, that also have your car key on them, can wear out and actually damage the ignition of your car. So instead of reducing the weight of my keys, I'm just going to make my car key detachable from the rest of my keys. Here's how. Using this small side release buckle, I'm going to take my first piece of paracord and pass the midpoint through one side of my buckle. Then with the running ends, I'm going to pass them through the connection point on my car key. From there, I'm going to pass the right running end through the top of the midpoint loop above. And then pass it through the buckle on the right side. Do the same on the other strand, pass it through the top loop, and then through the buckle on the same side. You might need a spike or FID to push the cord through. Your setup should look like this now. Then you're going to cinch up the cords and tighten everything up. Now once we have that knot cinched and tightened up, if you want to finish this the easy way, just snip, melt, and press down on the strands as they are here. Just make sure you leave enough cord when you melt it, so that when you press down on them, it will mushroom the tips out so that they lock in place. The slightly harder and more secure way is that I'm going to first snip off the excess paracord and leave about a quarter of an inch or about half a centimeter of excess. And the next part is going to be quick, so be ready. You're going to melt the ends of the cords with your lighter, and before they melt, quickly and very carefully press the molten ends together. You should definitely dip your fingers in water or wear a heat-resistant glove when doing this. So with that first side done, we're going to repeat the process on the other side. On the other side, we're going to pass the running ends through the buckle just like before, and the midpoint loop goes through a key ring. Bring the midpoint loop down, and like before, the running end cords are going to pass through the top of that loop. Firm up the knot so that you have both strands coming out the other side like so. And from here, repeat the process of cutting the excess strands, melting them slightly, and then before they cool, press them together carefully and do not burn yourself. And with that done, we have made our quick release keychain. We can now quickly detach and reattach the car key from the rest of the keys, thus saving the wear on the ignition. Now I think this is better than magnetic connectors because those can come undone, and I think magnets, if too strong, could actually interfere with the microchip of the car key. So of course this really only applies for this style of car key. It doesn't really apply to key fobs that don't need to be inserted into the car or keyless ignitions. However, if you just want to be able to detach your car key from your keys or any other piece of gear, this could work too. So I hope you found this video useful and informative. A huge thank you to my Patreon supporters who make videos like this possible. And also a huge thank you to the sponsor of this video, Keybar. Keybar is a US-made key organizer that can take the chaos of your keys from this to this. Using the Keybar takes the hassle out of finding the right key, and most importantly, it stops the noise. Keybars are made from high-quality materials like titanium, micarta, and aluminum. They can be tailored to your specific needs, and overall, it just makes using your keys a whole lot easier, hassle-free, and actually pretty cool. So I did a review on this very one you're looking at, and it has been working out exceedingly well for me. So if you want to stop the noise and bring some order to your keys, check out keybar.us and use discount code KBARMY to get 10% off your order. Thanks, Keybar.